Now to our series on the changing face of Melbourne and the remarkable transformation that will help us keep our title of the world's most livable city well into the future. It's a tough challenge for authorities as they try to balance a booming population with expensive infrastructure needs. They're looking at some radical options too, like an increase in vertical living and the construction of mini cities.
A river city, going up and out. Our CBD will double in size, expanding to Fisherman's Bend. And the existing city grid could be home to at least 7 new towers.
It'll feel like the world's most livable city still, but it will probably perform better.
Well, Melbourne in the future is going to be a lot bigger, a lot more dense, a lot more intense.
New mini cities will be developed. The outer suburbs will keep spreading in every direction to form the mini cities. The Western Corridor, including Sunbury and Diggers Rest, the Outer North, and the Southeastern Corridor, all growing at a rapid rate. The outskirts, like here at the Calcallo pub, will boom as people search for affordable homes.
We're ready for the future.
In Melbourne's changing face. We've always been a city with big plans. We've broken the $700,000 mark for the median house price. Our most expensive suburb is Toorak, but on a square metre basis, it's Albert Park. The most affordable is Melton. Young people flock to Richmond, renters, Carlton, and single people living alone choose St Kilda.
And let's take to the sky. To get some perspective on our changing city, it's best done from above.
A divide really is emerging in Melbourne's landscape. While the CBD continues to grow up, there's no end in sight to the urban sprawl. New mini cities are the way forward. Let's land and take a look.
I'm standing in a paddock that's about to be transformed. The first blocks of land have been sold behind me and work has started on Victoria's largest housing development.
The Cloverton development, 35 kilometres north of Melbourne, will eventually house more than 25,000 residents.
We're appealing to first home buyers and upgraders who are looking for a large lot and a big backyard.
Housing in Melbourne is among the least affordable in the world.
I think the way of the future to provide, you know, quality, affordable and diverse housing is through well-planned medium-density development.
Those medium-density developments will pop up in suburbs like here at East Brunswick, along existing public transport routes. High-density developments will increase in the city centre to help house the 1,800 new residents who are currently making Melbourne their new home each and every week.
You come into the city any time of the day or night, and this is where the action is.
I think it's a very exciting, next couple of decades.
A city where the sky's the limit.